In all of American history, we've only had 4 indictments of a U.S. president, and they all happened to the same man this year. So at what point are we going to stop pretending that this is normal? At what point are people going to stop trying to spin this? When will our media finally stop giving both sides and just lay out the facts? When will we stop putting liars on TV or allowing media networks to broadcast propaganda and call it news? At what point are we finally going to call a spade and be like, holy shit, we made a big mistake? The Republicans allowed a criminal to become their standard bearer, and they are scrambling now, throwing everything at the wall to try and justify or distract from what they knew to be true. We all knew from the beginning who this man was, and if so many hadn't personally benefited from Donald Trump, we might have avoided this. If his shady business dealings had actually been looked into, if someone had followed up on his taxes, on the dozens of sexual assault allegations, on his racist behavior towards his tenants or calling for the death penalty of the innocent Central Park Five, if we had just cut him loose when he mocked a disabled reporter or called Mexicans rapists or bragged about grabbing women by the pussy. We knew who he was, and we let it continue. We gave a narcissistic sociopath with no platform or moral compass, questionable business dealings, and sketchy foreign relationships access to the highest levels of government of the most powerful nation in the world. We made the thinnest skinned man practically untouchable. We can't be that surprised he didn't want to give it up. So here we are with American democracy literally hanging by a thread, with the leading Republican candidate for president indicted on everything from conspiracy against the United States to espionage, and he is still being supported by people who choose power over morality, ruling over governing, and profit over truth. This country is sick, and we need to break the fever. So remember that the DC indictment includes the fact that this president and his allies were willing to declare martial law and use the military on American citizens to put down any uprisings after they illegally stayed in power. This is the same man telling us that should he win again, his plan is to centralize the power of the federal government around the presidency and purge anyone who isn't 100% loyal to him. He is telling us he wants to be a dictator, and we are acting like this is just another election. The DC case is federal, the Georgia case is state, but both indictments lay out a detailed case of a criminal conspiracy to defraud the people of the United States. Every single thing you've heard about election interference, ballot irregularities, fake ballots, stolen elections, corrupted machines, were lies and projections from the party who wanted to stay in power against the will of the voter. Now, obviously, Donald Trump can never be given power again, but neither can the party who allowed this to happen and continues to support him now that they know what he's done. We right this ship one way. By holding everyone involved accountable and by decimating the party that endorsed it at the voting booth. Senator Lindsey Graham was right when he said, if we nominate Trump, we will be destroyed and we will deserve it. Well, you did, you are, and you do.